Welcome back, my name is Teresa, and I'm very much alive, or so I think I am. I have an awful garbage filthy mouth where sometimes, just sometimes, I tend to use the word fuck as a comma. I know, it's disgusting. I should be stopped, but I haven't. If you're not into that or weird stuff in general, this is definitely not the place for you. Feel free to X out the video here. No harm, no foul. But I'll remember our time fondly. Y'all, hi. We have so much elf to talk about. Like, so much elf. Like, a lot. Moral of the story, I've been playing around with these products for a hot minute now, and I have some thoughts on them. Some good, some bad, some indifferent. So come join me on this gross journey of self-discovering and not paying for useless garbage in 2021. So when e.l.f. released their mint collection, I picked up the majority of the collection, but I also picked up some things that are outside of the collection. So let's start with the first thing, the Mint Melt Cooling Primer.
Mint Melt Cooling Face Primer retails for $8. This gel texture primer multitasks to keep your makeup in place, moisturize your skin, and deliver a cooling sensation. It glides on silky smooth without that sticky feel and is bursting with skin-happy ingredients like hyaluronic acid and antioxidants, plus a refreshing vanilla mint scent.
Liar, liar, pants on fucking fire, okay? I'm gonna put that down because I'm mad at that thing. The claims that it makes, completely not true. This is sticky. This is what I imagine the floor feels like in a porno theater, okay? Think about that. This product would be awesome if you added it to paper to make your very own DIY horror flypaper. Homicidal maniac not included. When you squeeze this primer out, it's a very pretty mint green color. And as you massage it into your face, you feel it. Unlike other primers that have a moisturizing feel or even a cooling feel, this feels heavy on the skin. You fucking feel this. While it gives the appearance of drying down, this primer is still pretty tacky. Now, two primers that I use that kind of have a similar feel is the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip Primer, as well as the J1 Jelly Pack Primer. And I'm used to the slight tacked feel, but there's something that is so fucking different from this e.l.f. primer compared to those two primers. I feel this shit on my skin. It feels like it radiates heat, okay? I know it's supposed to be cooling, but I just feel it on my skin and I just want to scratch my fucking face off. I really do. I hate it. I hate it. I don't like it. Get away from me, Susan. I don't like it. This shit is like a layer of cement on my face. That's probably the best way I can describe it. Sticky, wet cement that yet somehow looks dry. I don't fucking understand it. Moving past that, when I applied the CC cream to it, holy shit. Oh, man. It did three things to my face. It dried me out. It created a very weird powder texture on my skin. And the CC cream never stayed in place. It would just slip and slide all over the fucking place. It was a fucking Daytona 500 all over my face, okay? Shit was just moving everywhere. And it wasn't cute. Nope, not at all. It didn't smooth, it didn't hydrate my face. Instead, it really dried it out. And I still don't understand how the product created such a weird powder film to my face, but it did. I feel like the primer was actually turning me into powder. And I'm working on bending spoons as we speak. If you're looking for a nice cooling primer, this is not it. Don't even bother looking at it. Like, look away. Instead, I recommend the Ofra Cooling Primer, which I think is called Cool as a Cucumber, this one right here. Get that. Look at that. Don't fuck with this thing. Even for $8. Don't even. I don't recommend this. Go far away from it, please. Let's move on to more complexion products.
The Camo CC Cream retails for $14. Ditch your basic foundation. This skin color correcting cream is the only product you need to achieve a natural looking complexion, but with full coverage. A multitasking dream cream. Ew. With peptides and niacinamide known to plump, hydrate, and smooth the appearance of your skin while protecting with SPF. Also infused with skin-loving collagen.
So this CC cream is a medium to full coverage with a natural finish. It has SPF 30, and this CC cream is supposed to have skincare benefits. I'm a fan of the IT Cosmetics CC cream. It's not my most favorite thing, but I've always enjoyed it when I've had it in my possession. I really love the matte one more than the other two finishes because even though it says it's matte, it's not really matte, it's more of a natural finish. Highly recommend it. It's really good in the summertime. I had a lot of high hopes for this particular CC cream. Oh man, I really did. I don't know why everything from the Camo line fucks my face up, but it does. It fucks my face up. I haven't found one camo product that I like. From the concealers, both concealers actually, this thing, I can't. Like, the only thing that I really like in e.l.f.'s complexion products is the Flawless line. I've enjoyed both the concealer and the foundation. Love them, have them in my collection. One of my favorite drugstore options. The camo one though, something just does not agree with my skin. Anyway, I want to try this because I'm a glutton for punishment. So before I dog this shit, let me tell you a little bit more about it. This product comes in 20 shades with 3 different undertones, which is cool, neutral, warm, and I chose 120N. I think I probably could have went with a little bit of a darker shade because this is a little bit too light on my skin, but you know what? It wasn't a bad match. I found this to be a true medium coverage. You can build it up to full coverage, I just don't recommend it. And the reason for that is because when I build it up on my skin, it just gets cakier and heavier. And the natural finish that I was hoping for now just looks like a caked matte mask. Fucking gross. I have normal to dry skin, but lately it's been a little bit more drier since we're in winter. I have used this product with so many different primers. I used it with this primer, I used it with Tatcha Silk Canvas, Fenty Hydrating Primer, Charlotte Tilbury, Maya Chia, Ofra, Milani, and even no primer. I had the same experience whether I use primer or no matter what primer I choose, I had the same experience. I will say though that this e.l.f. primer was by far the worst out of all of them though. I think when I first applied this product for the first 25 minutes, my face looks beautiful. I look like a porcelain doll. I don't even look real. And we love that, right? Here's my issue though. My face starts to settle, kind of like a house. And then this wonderful layer of asbestos appears on my skin. What, you've never been to a public school in Queens? I had a very colorful childhood, what can I say? Anyway, there's a powdery film that solidifies my face. Mind you, this is without putting setting powder on my face, okay? Like, this does dry down, but it dries down to this fucking thick powder. It's awful. A couple of times I actually used my beloved child, Chantecaille. I used the blurring powder just in hopes that it will fix shit. No, it didn't. It actually made things worse if that was possible. I was like, what the fuck's going on? My skin looked so heavy and so cake-like. So when I was using this product, I wasn't setting my face at all because this thing kind of dries down to weird powder. Yet it doesn't dry down completely, so you kind of need a little bit of powder because I would often find that when I would have glasses on, it would leave indents. Or say if I was resting my hand on my face, I noticed that some of the product would be lifted up. So it's deceiving because it feels like it's dried down, but not really. Around the 3-hour mark, I noticed that my chin would get like a nice oil patch. And I'm pretty sure this is the product that has been causing me to break out here and here. I'm pretty fucking sure it's this bitch right here. I can say though, that this product does have a nice longevity because I feel like around the 8-hour mark, everything still looked pretty intact and that would make sense because my face was drying down to fucking cement. Since this product does add a layer of dust to my face, it definitely accentuates some of the dry bits that I have around my nose and some dryness over by my temple area. And I'm sure if it gets any drier, people will start excavating my face to find a fucking megalodon tooth. I'm pretty sure of it. So yeah, fuck this product, fuck it in its fucking face, I fucking hate it. Get the fuck away from me. I thought the primer was bad, but no, I actually think this is somehow worse. So yeah, the first 25 minutes are fine, and then I turn into the fucking Crypt Keeper. So that's a pass for me. Bye, bye, go away.
e.l.f. Putty Blushes retails for $6. Say hello to the Island Glow. This lightweight but buildable putty to powder blush blends seamlessly into skin, infused with argan oil and vitamin E for some added nourishment. This silky smooth buildable formula will give you a flush from within glow.
So this product comes in 8 shades, and this is marketed as a highly pigmented, creamy formula that blends into your skin and gives you that natural glow. So this is a cream to like a semi-matte powder finish. And this is infused with argan oil and vitamin E. If you're gonna get anything today, get these two things and the blush brush. Like, don't get anything else. Everything else sucks. Just get these products. Everything else is fucking awful. For me, e.l.f. kills it when it comes to blushes. And I love the little bite-sized duos. I think they're phenomenal. I think I pretty much have almost all of them. After today, I'm definitely gonna be picking up more of these. These are so incredibly easy to use. They're very pigmented. So for me, what I would do is I would use the putty blush brush which is sold separately, by the way. And this is basically a duo fiber synthetic brush. I would just swirl it a little bit into the pan, and then I would use the back of my hand just to get the excess off, because like I mentioned, this shit is pretty fucking pigmented. I made the mistake a couple of times of just swirling and swirling and swirling and then immediately popping it onto my cheek. It looked cute, but I definitely look like a fucking Annabelle doll, and I was like, okay, nobody has time for that shit. For me, I find the best way to apply it is apply it a little bit to the back of the hand, and then when it's a little bit kind of like muted, then I start going to town on my face. And I just love this little like natural glow from within. Looks like somebody pinched my cheeks. I look adorable. I love it. I feel like a Campbell soup kit. This blush is so good. It was so fucking good. It applies very easily. It doesn't dry down too fast. You're able to blend the product into your skin. I didn't find that this product picks up the foundation underneath. I have used this product with and without setting powder first, and I will say that you can actually even get away with putting a little bit of setting powder down and applying this blush right on top of it. It doesn't pull up the powder too much. Like maybe a little bit really isn't that bad, and it's really not that noticeable. This blush does dry down, and even though it's semi-matte, I guess I would consider it a natural finish. I think out of all the drugstore cream blush products, these I think might be my favorite. These are fucking good. They're really good. So like I mentioned, I bought two of the blushes, and the first one is from, which by the way, a lot of people were pointing out in my last video that the name of the product is actually on this very, very small clear label. And yeah, you can see it. I would say that's probably my only complaint, is that sometimes it's really hard to see what the fucking shade name is, because you're like, what is it, bitch? But it looks like I got the shade. Oh my God, where are you? Ah, Turks and Caicos and Bora Bora. So Turks and Caicos is a very pretty apricot color, and Bora Bora is a very beautiful bubblegum pink color, which is actually what I currently have on my cheeks today, because I'm wearing green. I'm green and pink mix. I'm so cute. Anyway, I'm happy to say too that even though I only had two of these blushes, and I can't really speak for the rest of the line, there wasn't any product differences between the two of these blushes. They both applied the same way. They both had a great longevity. I had no issue. They're really awesome, and that's what makes me excited to go purchase other ones from this collection. Again, if you get anything today, just get the blushes and get the little duo fiber brush. This is fucking awesome. And I mean, unless you have a duo fiber brush in your collection, I don't think you really need another one, but I don't. I think that's something that I don't have in my collection. And this little brush retails for $4, so highly, highly recommend getting this one. The last things I want to talk about are these two eyeshadow palettes from e.l.f. Cosmetics.
Mini Melt Eyeshadow Palettes retails for $4 each. Pigment packed mini eyeshadow quads featuring a minty mix of matte and shimmer shades.
So listen, I picked up both in hopes that, you know, they're gonna be good. I'm pretty sure you've noticed throughout the course of this fucking video, one of my eyes is leaking. Yeah. Don't recommend this shit. I just don't. Let's talk about the worst one first. And the worst one is, what the fuck is this one called? Mint to Be. This one sucks. This one fucking sucks. There are two matte shades and there are two shimmer shades in this palette. The lightest color, which is a light green, is so light that it actually doesn't show up on me. So, yep. And then the shade next to that is actually the darkest matte, which is this beautiful dark green. And it's really, really pretty. But the longevity is a joke. And it started to fade after a few hours of being on my eyeball. So that was cool. The shimmers already hit hard pan. And they're not smooth as, say, this palette or other bite-sized palettes. These are fucking hard, and they have a grit to them that is just, it's not appealing. It doesn't feel good, and you definitely don't want that shit on your fucking eyeballs. It feels like sandpaper. They are barely pigmented, but once you do scratch a layer off and you spackle the shadow onto your fucking face, it's glitter bukkake central. This was fucking terrible. Terrible. Highly, highly do not recommend this. Fuck this palette. So the next palette is the Chocolate Mint palette. Now listen, if I'm gonna compare these together, this is obviously A plus, amazing. Everybody and their mother should get this palette. If I'm comparing it to other e.l.f. bite-sized palettes, this can go fuck itself. Like, fuck this fucking palette and its fucking face. Like, it's fucking terrible. And I'll tell you why. There are definitely longevity issues with this palette. I don't get it. Like, the matte shades are a little bit better, I would say, both the light brown and the dark brown. They're not bad, but the dark brown, I don't know, maybe it's just the darker colors within this line, but after a couple of hours, they start to bald out pretty quickly. As for the shimmer shades, they didn't hit hard pan, which is nice, but ironically enough, when you put these two shadows together, they kind of look the same, which doesn't make sense because one is clearly a mint green. green, and the other one is kind of like a champagne-y pearl color, yet they look exactly the same on the eye. I don't fucking understand it myself. And there's something in the champagne color that's irritating the shit out of me because all I could feel is just wetness. Gooey, gooey wetness. Ew, 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 ew. No. Like, I hate this so much. I hate this. I was liking Elf for a hot minute. I don't know what happened, but this shit is atrocious. All of it, except for the putty blushes. Those are my heart. But anyway, let me keep going about this. The shimmer shades did wear better than the other shimmer shades from the Mint to Be palette, and I paired it with some glitter glue and I had no issue. There is a light glitter bukkake, but there's still a glitter bukkake moment. And that's pretty much all the nice things that I have to say about it. Like, I think if you really wanted to get something, I don't know why you would. I guess get the mint chocolate mint, whatever the fuck it is, chocolate mint. Why can't you just call it mint chocolate? It bothers me, it's called chocolate mint. Okay, whatever. It's just my own hangups, I guess, right? Oh, anyway, this is the other thing I don't understand. These are $4, but the other bite size collection is $3, and you get 4 shadows. So I don't really understand the difference. Are you paying $1 for fucking green packaging? In any case, I don't know what happened to Elf. I don't know why they steered clear from the bite size formula, but they need to fucking go back. That bite size formula is fantastic. And for $3, it's like mind blowing how fucking awesome it is. This for $4, I was like, okay, well maybe it's gonna like step it up. No, if anything, it fucking went, it reverted back into hell. What the fuck is this? Like, what is this? What is this? Who asked for this? No. So I'm gonna say pass on both of these, and yeah, they gotta go. They gotta go after this. They gotta go. Packing their bags and you're getting the fuck out of here. Anyway, so let's recap here. What you should get, if you're gonna get anything, just get the putty blush, just get the brush. Skip everything else. Everything else can go fuck itself. Anyway, now I wanna hear from y'all. Let me know down below how you feel about these products, if you love them, if you hate them. We have different opinions. You're wrong. That's fine. I'm telling you right now, you're wrong. These are bad. These are fucking bad. Oh, these are bad. But hey, but if you like them though, it's great. That's good for you. Your face obviously doesn't reject this shit, and that's awesome. For me, my face is like, no, get it away from me. And that's okay. We can all have different opinions here, but you just know you're wrong. Okay, on that note, I want to say for watching. I truly appreciate it as always. Feel free to like, comment, hit that motherfucking subscribe button because it's motherfucking free, and hit that bell icon for notifications of all my future posts. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Patreon. To all my beautiful, wonderful Patreon bubbies, thank you so much for just being adorable and delicious and adorably delicious. And thank you so much for keeping this disgusting, filthy garbage boat afloat. I couldn't do it without you. And I love you. I love you all. I'm just gonna pinch your little cheekies and it's gonna be magical. If you wanna know what is currently on my face, if you wanna know where to get my podcast and my merch and bloopity blop blop, everything will, again, will be listed in the description box below. And I'll see you little pumpkins later. Bye.